Okay, this is just like a little talk about, I don't know, I wrote that last video over the cooler. I made a step ladder double. I put one ladder, crushed it, put it together, and then I put it with another ladder like that, and then I tied them with rope. So I made my own extension ladder. And with that extension ladder, what happens? Well, it got taller. I had like 100 inches then, and then so then I put that on the roof, and I went up there, and then I undid that cooler at the bottom with a bolt. It's a plastic bolt. You undo that, and then it drains out. But unfortunately, there's a bolt in there that went further into the machine, and so you need that to return in springtime, because that's what you have to rebolt it to make the water stop. And so anyway, so I did that, lost it up into the machine. So but all of this is going on the roof, so I went up there, and I am when I get in the heights, I get dizzy, and I am like very nervous of heights that much. But I did it anyway, and but in the spring it looks like I have to open up the sides of it with a screwdriver. Hopefully a screwdriver does that. I don't need something electric, because if I can't do many trips up to the roof, you know, it's impossible. So anyway, and then I also discovered roof damage from the water, from the cooler that was older, the older one there. So yeah, it was, I did it, okay, I did it. I made a two-step ladder extension to get up to the blasted height without scaffolds. And many hoots. I'm showing off a little bit of my book collection. I have a lot of books. Let's see what we have here. This one is a really good little artist. It's called The Wonders of the Desert, and it's written by Louis Sabin, illustrated by Pamela Baldwin Ford. Now, Pamela Baldwin Ford is an incredible artist. A lot of these are water-based. I'll show you this page. It's just amazing. With the rabbits. Very, very true to life, like an Aesop's. Gorgeous rabbit. And here on the mountain is a coyote. It's very much like a wash. One of the jackrabbit's enemies is the coyote. It has a bushy tail and looks very much like a dog. At night, the coyote's lonely howl carries over the desert. Oh my gosh. Ooh. All of this is going on in this book. It's almost a little bit factual, because it tells you the jackrabbit eats, the jackrabbit, like the rats and mice of the desert, does not drink much water. It gets all the water it needs from the plants it eats. When it is being chased, the jackrabbit can jump 15 feet or 4.5 meters in a single leap. So it's a little bit factual there. We get 15 feet and apparently no water. They just gobble the plants. That's incredible. And look how fast. That one's really remembered by this artist, Pamela Baldwin Ford. Very, very good and fun. Yeah, we have skunks in here and everything. It's got a lot of desert animals. Very interesting. So yeah, I'm kind of liking this. This book, it has snakes. She put snakes in there. You know, you always have to have the snakes. But yeah, that's nice. So I have this, you know, I have like so many books, you can't even believe. These are like all my childhood books. This one's, funnily enough, published by Troll Associates. Because here we are on the internet. Troll Associates. Yeah. I don't know. You know, I don't, and then they say, what condition is it? I don't, it looks pretty good to me, but somebody would maybe say it's good, somebody would say it's like new, somebody would say it's very good. It's tough, the qualification of what a book is. It doesn't have any writing on it, so I would say it's very good. It's got a few crinks in the cover. You see those crinks? That type of thing makes it tougher to say it's a like new, because when you have the cranks, I probably have it listed though like new. I don't know, but anyway, she's a great one. Wonders of the Desert, that one is. So what I did, I framed some of my paintings today, and the framing is okay, but I made a few disasters with gluing. I made a back frame and then I glued the painting to the back frame because I didn't have a border that fit this. And when I did that, I didn't use a roller, and so I ended up with bumps. So there's bumps in the painting underneath. You can't see it right now, but they're there. So it's kind of the only way to get rid of the bumps is to take the whole painting out and cut the thing out like with a razor blade. I have to go underneath and score it, and I don't know, it might actually damage the whole thing, so I'm maybe stuck with the bumps forever. But I'm sure that happens to a lot of artists. We end up with the bumps. Anyway, this is olives, just olives. It's kind of fun. And then what else? Oh, I've been painting today. I primer painted even this frame, and it's tacky still. I'm not happy with it. A lot of the primer coloring. I did the doorknobs, and I saw a woman on these shows, and she did her doorknobs. And I went and I got the same stuff, but it's still tacky, the touch. So I'm not sure what's going on. Because it's already been 24 hours or more, and now they're still tacky to touch. I'm not sure when it's going to dry. Anyway, so I'm on this pumpkin phase at the moment where I'm eating lots and lots of pumpkin. I got over 10. Squash and pumpkins varieties for, you know, the storeway for winter. And so, you know, a lot of the big jack-o'-lantern styles, everything. And I'm cutting them up, I'm juicing them, and then the pulp I'm turning into smoothies. And apparently these smoothies are making me paint. I'm painting doors next. I think I'm going to haul off the front door and paint it. I'm just in one of those moods to paint everything, paint all the doors in the house. Ay, ay, ay. But anyway, that's exhausting. Getting up on the roof is exhausting because it's something that I'm nervous to do, and so it gets my adrenaline. It's an adrenaline robber. You know, it robs that energy a moment. Yeah, it's like a devastating, and I'm woozy. I'm dizzy woozy. up there in the heights. And the first thing is, because the ladder did not reach the roof line exactly, only the top of the ladder reached. It didn't do over like normal extension ladders. I know I'm going on about this, but it's the scariest thing ever. So when I walked on, I literally was like, oh my gosh, just one knee at a time over the ladder, you know, and then holding on to the side because it's a very steep roof. And I'm like, if I slide now, that's it, you know. If I slide now, I'm out, you know, something's gonna hit. And it has like those shingles, and the shingles, and that one zone has shingles, and it's very slippery. So now I'm holding on to the tile, so that there's tiles there, like regular roof tiles. But like, you know, ballet holding on, so not too tight, because if I hold it too tight, they might break the tile free, and so, but yet, you know, it's, everything has to be just enough that I can stay on the roof, you know that gingerly, you have to touch things gingerly. In those situations, yuck. Anyway, $90 for extension ladders. I believe I had a ladder. I don't know where it went. I had one, and it was like $35 or something a long, long time ago. But since gone to somebody else. And anyway, that's all. I don't have anything to say aside from I think the pumpkin smoothies, if y'all are making them, with the dates and the pumpkin mash, and you can add the almond milk, and you can add cocoa if you want, and you can even add like an agave nectar. There's something else that you add. I can't remember. You can add banana also. But all of these things together are like fattening, but I don't know. They're giving me a lot of energy. I don't know if... Then I read pumpkin isn't fattening. Pumpkin itself isn't fattening, but I have a feeling when you start adding all those sweet items. Yeah. Anyway, so what a fun book. Fun little book. Just makes me want to be a little kid again and read it. Wonders of the Desert. And even look at the font. Really, really, you know, care. When they made this, they really took care of it. Yeah. Alrighty, guys. That's it. Except paint. Yeah, paint these tract neighborhoods up. Some of them are so boring. You know, they just went with the standard paint that they bought by the millions, you know, and then the people move in their houses and they can't, you know, modify. My gosh, if you can, please. I can barely modify, but I believe a lot of you can modify much better than me. So do it. It's good for everything. Good for the house prices, and condominiums. Condominium owners need to also modify. They're very, very lax, I find, some of them. They're not doing enough. They just maintain, you know, and they don't try to enhance their condominiums after they've built them, you know. So shame on them. I don't know how to get after condominium owners, because they can really bring neighborhoods down. Shame on them.